Hello, everyone, and welcome to another PC Part Picker live stream. I'm Ryan.
And I'm Barry.
And today we're doing another mini ITX build for our trip to DreamHack Austin. We have the BitPhoenix Portal here today for our case, which BitPhoenix has kindly provided for us.
And MSI also provided us with the Z270i Gaming Pro Carbon AC motherboard that we'll be putting inside of it.
Yeah, we have the full description, or we have the full part list in the description below. So why don't we get started here?
Alrighty. I'm going to kind of stick the case over to the side for right now.
Alright, I'll hide behind it.
And we'll get started with our motherboard.
Alright.
So, first, strap in.
Yes. You have your anti-static wrist strap.
Yep.
To protect components from any possible damage here.
Exactly.
Yeah, it's a few bucks, and it's a nice security precaution.
Alright. Inside here, we're going to go ahead and take out our motherboard. And also going to take out our I/O shield, which we'll need in a moment.
Mm-hmm.
And then an RGB header, because we will be putting in
RGB extension cable.
Yeah, RGB extension cable for this. And then we also have some SATA ports, the manual, and our Wi-Fi antennas.
Yeah. But since we're using an M2 drive with this build, we don't need any SATA cables.
Right. And we're going to be using the i7-7700K in this. So we're going to pop that out.
Yeah, this is a power-packed little build.
Yes.
i7, it's a 1080 Ti.
Yes.
I think that's it's the first one we've built with so far.
Yeah, first one.
I'm excited. It's a white graphics card, white case, white cooler. I think it's going to look pretty cool.
It's going to look very good. All right, so we'll go ahead and open our latch here. Raise it up. Okay. Take the CPU out. Match the pin 1 indicator with the pin 1 indicator on the motherboard and just gently place it down in there.
Yeah, there's a gold triangle on the CPU and it looks like a little white circle.
Yep.
On the printed on the PCB there.
And the cover just pops off and you're good to go.
Yep.
So we're RAM. We're using Corsair Vengeance LPX memory.
16 gigabytes?
Yeah, 16 gigabytes. Okay. So also white.
Mm-hmm. And the DIMMs will only fit one way, so if it's not going in right away,
don't force it.
Check it. It might need to be flipped around.
Just push down here, click. And the other one. And another click. And we're good. We're going to be using the Corsair MP500 NVMe 480 gigabyte SSD for this one.
Okay.
So we'll go ahead and pull this out. My screwdriver ready. Then we'll flip the motherboard over on the back.
Right, because it mounts on the back side for this
actually
board.
It mounts
right?
on the back.
Okay.
The screw's already in it. You just need to unscrew this. Just place it in. That's all it's.
Yeah, it's pretty straightforward. It'll only fit one direction, and then it's one little screw.
Screw it back in, and good to go. We're going to go ahead and pull out our cooler. We're using the Captain 120EX today in white, black and white. So we kind of have a theme going on. And we're going to go ahead and pull out the back plate for the cooler.
Right.
And go ahead and put that on. So in here, it's got a bag and it's got your parts labeled for Intel or AMD.
Okay.
So we're going to be using the Intel. We'll pull out our back plate and hardware for that. We'll stick this one. Oh, less than your fan screws.
Good call. Yeah, it's a fairly simple installation process on this one.
Yeah. And we'll just take our screws, and we'll be using, on the back plate here, it's got 115X, and that's mm-hmm. going to be the one we're using. You
right.
just basically just push these screws in there, or pull them through, and they just kind of snap in place, which is nice, because then you're not fighting with yourself trying to get it to go into the
right.
motherboard and your screws falling out. Place it down in there, and then we'll just kind of hold it in the place as we pull it back over.
Yep, nice and easy.
Yep.
Sometimes with the shorter screws on the back plates, they can be a bit of a pain to fall out when you flip it over, but with the long screws, it's nice and easy.
All right, and with these, we're going to put our post down, and you basically just put it rubber side down. It's got mm-hmm. one side that has a rubber piece, one piece that doesn't. You just kind of just thread
screw them on.
Yep.
You don't want to crank these down, but they should be secure.
Yeah, you want to put them on there snug, but you don't also want to just keep turning and turning and turning and turning.
Right.
All right, so next we have our crossbars, and we're going to put them across the top. Mm-hmm. Is the way we're going to orient our block. So you just slide these on here.
Yeah, we tested out a couple different
right.
orientations. We tested out both orientations for these brackets, and we found that this one will mount a little bit better
yeah.
when we put everything in the case.
Yep. And then you just take these little thumb screws right here, and again, you just screw these down. Again, you want to make sure they're snug, but you don't want to just keep cranking them down. There we go. All right, and while we're here,
okay.
because of the placement, we're going to be using a fan extension for the front fan, so we're going to go ahead and attach that right here.
Right.
To SysFan 1.
Yeah, because as soon as we start plugging in the rest of the components, putting the cooler on, access to the motherboard becomes much more difficult,
yes.
if not impossible, to some of the places.
Correct. So we'll just kind of set that off. Side, and then we're also going to go ahead and put on our RGB header extension.
Oh, okay.
Because it's located right here.
Behind that Wi-Fi?
Yeah, behind the Wi-Fi. And once we put the motherboard into the case, it's got a rear case fan. If we don't mm-hmm. want to have to remove the rear case fan, we'll go ahead and have this here. So we'll go ahead and put that there. And see here.
Yeah. You want to make sure you put this on the correct
Yep, put it in the correct direction. Way. So it's got a white block around, mm-hmm. which is your 12-volt. So, and we looked in the manual beforehand. Just slide it down.
Yeah,
just attach that.
Generally speaking, on the connectors or the cables, the one with the arrow.
Yeah, it'll have an arrow.
Is 12 volt is power.
Yep. All right. So I think that's everything we can do with the motherboard.
Okay.
For right now. So let me just kind of bring it over here out of the way for a second.
Need the case from me?
We'll need the case.
All right. Sliding stuff around inside. It's a solid case. I mean, this is all metal.
Yeah.
For the most part, I mean, just about everything.
Yeah. And they do come in white or black, with mm-hmm. or without a window. The window isn't where you would normally expect it, though.
Yeah.
The window is actually up top right here, which I think gives it a nice, unique feel,
right.
unique look.
Right.
So, all right. And then accessing the case is also a little bit different. So we'll kind of turn it to the side. Yeah. You have two thumb screws down here at the bottom. Pull the case out.
Wow.
Which is nice. And it's got a rail on the inside, so you don't want to really push down on it or anything like that.
You
don't want to warp the rail.
Be careful.
And then we'll slide it out. And you can also see, because it slides out, they have extra long front I.O. For everything.
All right.
To be able to reach everything. And
you just want me to set this down or off to the side?
Yeah, if you want to set it down, that'd be good.
Yeah, get out of the way here.
So,
for right now.
So this, we're going to be putting a radiator up front. It also has room for, it's got an SSD mount right here,
mm-hmm.
two 3.5-inch drives right here, or SSDs
right.
That are easily removable. So we're going to go ahead and set it down, though. Before we put in the motherboard, the standoffs are pre-installed.
Right.
But to make things a little bit easier, we are going to take off this rear panel right here.
Okay.
Just so we're not doing such a harsh angle on our screws, because we don't want to strip anything out. We want to make sure everything's actually secured in there nicely. So we're going to go ahead and remove this, which is just two screws on either side.
Right.
And then set it off to the side.
Yeah, because it does kind of overlap, and if you're having to come back in
right.
to touch components or unscrew things, it's a little bit more difficult.
Yeah. Go ahead and prep our power supply, because
right.
once we get the power supply, or once we start putting the motherboard in, it kind of gets a little bit tight in there. So if we can go ahead and do the cables for the power supply, put the power supply in there, get it out of the way, it makes it a whole lot easier.
Yeah, it's a little bit of an unorthodox order for an unorthodox case.
Yes. So. And we're using the Corsair SF 600, which is it's very powerful. It's 600 watts, but it's also tiny.
Yeah, it's surprising how small. I mean, we've used several of these SFX power supplies now, but they're so tiny.
Yes.
Yeah, so inside you got your, what is it, warranties and a manual.
Yeah, warranties and a manual. You've got your little accessories, which is some zip ties and some screws for the power supply. And then here's
your little baby
power supply. Set that right there. We'll go ahead and get out our cables. We'll need a 24-pin, and then we'll need a...
8-pin EPS.
Yeah, 8-pin EPS.
And then 8 and a 6-pin PCIe for the 1080 Ti.
Yep. There we go.
So just about every cable.
Yeah, almost every cable.
Yeah. This thing's thankfully no SATA, no Molex, but...
Yeah. Right. So we'll start with our 24-pin. It's basically, they've got everything labeled for you, so you just match it up, and then just push it in. You hear a little click.
They're nice short cables, too.
Yeah, they are.
Is that the EPS cable?
Yep. Put it right there. And then we have our PCIe for the graphics card.
Gotcha. Are those both 6 plus 2s?
Yeah, they're both 6 plus 2s. No, they are not daisy chained. So if you've got an 8 and a 6 or 2 8s, you will need to use both cables.
Okay.
So so there's venting on the bottom of the case. So we're going to put the fan facing down, pull in cool air, exhaust it out the back. So just pull these cables to the side.
About there, yeah.
So we get our screws out of the accessory box. So with the SFX power supply, this one actually uses 6 screws instead of the standard 4.
Yeah.
So we've got...
It's a smaller power supply, but more secure than regular ATX units.
So since I've got the accessory box out, so I pulled out our 6... 6 power supply screws. Mm-hmm. We've also got varying fan screws and hard drive screws for a hard drive bays and zip ties. And it also comes with an Allen wrench and a speaker in case you need to plug into your motherboard to get your debug codes. And then the pull these sleds out. So basically, the hard drive sleds have basically every option that you could ask for.
Yeah, I see that.
With rubber grommets.
Anti-vibration.
Yeah, anti-vibration and everything like that. So, and it's got plenty of screws for you to use two of them, and it's got two of these that you can fit in there, which is nice and kind of a lot for a smaller smaller case.
Because the case really isn't that, like, the internals of the case really aren't that large. I mean, the shell kind of adds some space just for flare, but... Good?
All right, well, you're good.
All right.
So we can install the motherboard now.
All righty.
So I'm going to pull these cables out of my way. I'll push this one down to the side.
Ooh, always, almost forgot the...
Yeah, do not forget to install your I.O. shield. And this one goes in a little bit different because of the orientation of the of the motherboard. So basically just put it in there. And this is also one of our favorites.
Padded.
It's padded. Saves your fingers.
Yep.
So just push in. Should hear clicks, or you'll hear it, feel it kind of clicking on the sides. So there we go. Now we'll go ahead and install our motherboard. Kind of drape these cables that we pre-installed over here. And just set it in place.
Adverse aspect of saying it'd be really cool if they made different outer frames that kept the same inner frame. Kind of the definition of modding. I mean, if you get the white one, you can pretty much do anything with it. You can paint it any colors you wanted.
That's true. So we'll go ahead and secure it.
I think it'd be interesting to see one. Like, I love the design of the case, but it'd be interesting to see one with a window on the side, too.
Oh, that'd be interesting.
Because we have all these pretty components, but you can only see in the top.
Yeah, that is true.
So, all the glamour shots are for the internals kind of extended out.
Alright. While we're right here, we're just going to go ahead and connect our 24-pin mm-hmm. and our 8-pin.
Yeah.
Kind of move our PCIe cables off to the side for now.
And as you mentioned, it is a little bit different order for things, for plugging components in.
Yeah, just because when it's such a tiny case, tiny motherboard, once you get too far, you start adding stuff, it gets a little bit more difficult to start plugging stuff in. So if it's not going to be in your way,
yeah.
I see no problem with going ahead and just plugging it in.
Yeah.
Our 24-pin.
Yeah, it's over by me.
Let's get out of my way. There we go. Go ahead and hook up our back fan.
Right.
Because
it's kind of tucked.
Yeah, it's kind of tucked. So we'll go ahead and get it out of our way. So let me do this, and it can be powered via Molex or the header. We are just doing it by the header. I'm not doing it by Molex.
Yeah.
So
SMJ Virtual is also asking about using sleeved cables. Honestly, with this case, you'd probably want to go custom, because you want to get them about as small as you can get them. If you didn't make them yourself, to go even shorter.
Yeah.
In the distance from the power supply to that 24 pin is shorter than I think they'll even sell you customs by a long shot.
Yeah.
So if you really want to clean up the cables, you kind of want to make your own.
Yeah, and because if you use extension, you're adding length, and then that length has to go somewhere.
You're adding a lot of thickness, too, with each cable.
You're also adding some thickness. So I would say if you wanted colored cables or, you know, white or black or a mixture or something like that, I would say, you know, go full custom with custom lengths and everything like that. That way you can get it exactly how you want it.
And these are pretty easy to bend. I mean, they're easy to bend and trim.
Oh, yeah.
They get a little bulky, but you end up with taking up a lot more space when you go with sleeved cables.
So I'm going to just zip tie this Molex.
Okay. Yeah, we don't need to use that.
Over here, just so he's not bouncing around on the inside of the case. And I'm just basically just going ahead and cable managing this just to go ahead and get it out of our way, because it's kind of a longer cable for the short distance I have to plug it in. Pull out the fan. Here, go ahead and remove this front fan, because we're gonna be using the fan that comes with the
Decool. Yeah, the Captain.
This fan, just set it to the side. We looked at our different configurations. Man, go ahead and do this guy also. Yeah.
We set it on all four ways.
Yeah, we put it on all four ways to see which way we thought would work the best. And basically, the way we ended up we're going to go is we're basically going to run the tubes along the bottom, mm-hmm. Have the radiator here, fan in front of it, and then just mount this guy down in there.
Yeah, it keeps the tubes away from like the graphics card, and we're basically just running them against the cables then, which we can tuck back in kind of into that drive cage a little bit.
So, kind of slide this guy in here. Do this one just easy.
Yeah, that'll work for you.
So, kind of pull this cable out of my way. I don't want him to get trapped because I'll need him in a second.
Right. Yeah, we usually try to do them with the fan attached to the radiator, then you attach the radiator to the case. It's a little bit easier to do that your first time around, or when you only have one fan, it's not too bad. With the 240 over the 360, trying to kind of like hold up three fans and a radiator and line them up and screw them in can be a little challenging.
Yeah. I want to make sure of our placement, because it's got, basically, you can kind of adjust it up and down right here.
Mm-hmm.
So, but we don't want to go too far up, because then we have a graphics card right here. So.
Right. SN Virtual had another question, or kind of statement, basically saying you wish there was a fan grill on the front, because the I.O. cables might hit that fan. When we put it together, I don't think we had any
Yeah.
We didn't have any issues. It's pretty easy to route them away from it, so you should be fine there.
Yeah, I'll show you in a second whenever I set it up, but it's actually got a little cut out here that you can run your I/O cables through, and then you kind of stay away from that fan.
That's fine. Once you have two or three of them in already,
yeah.
The fourth one's not so bad. This is another area of the build. You just want to make sure it's secure.
Yeah. You don't want to over-tighten it, but you also don't want to have it loose where it's going to be sliding around.
So thermal paste is already pre-applied, but I am going to go ahead and plug in our CPU fan,
Which is right here.
All right,
there we go.
Got it.
I'm gonna pop this off.
And then you basically just line it up with your holes.
Yep, one screw on either side.
Yep. And just tighten it down. Do one side a little bit, then you'll do the other side, basically just so you don't, you're not pulling the screw out.
Yeah. Adverse aspects that ITX cases make me glad I have lady hands. Honestly, this case is pretty open.
It is.
You know, there are some tight aspects in the corners there that you want to plug things in beforehand like we've done, but it's not too bad.
No. And then we'll also go ahead and plug in we put our fan extension on, we're going to go ahead and plug it into the cable here.
Right.
So, actually, the fan extension is not going to work.
Oh, we have to use a different one? That's only a 3-pin?
Yeah, I grabbed the wrong one.
Okay.
Alright.
So, we'll have to grab our other extension then. Find another one of those.
Yeah, let me pull this out.
Let's see. Jack's running to find you a 4-pin.
Okay. Oh, fantastic. Thank you. Jack's gonna
be our rescue. Alright. Alright, so we can go ahead and move on though. We can go to the graphics card because it's right there. So this one's not actually too bad to get to.
Okay. Oh, yeah. The power in the build.
Yes, the goodness.
Yeah.
We're using a U-Byte GTX 1080 Ti.
Right.
And this one is white.
Right, we specifically picked this one because it is white. Matches the rest of the theme in the build. And with a case like the Portal, you know, you have that window showing off the top, which is going to be your graphics card. We just wanted something cool.
Yeah.
Like, there are plenty of cards that'll fit.
Yeah. We wanted something that would look pretty awesome.
Look nice, look impressive.
Yeah.
A little bit surprising too. Pretty small build, and then a 1080 Ti up at the top there.
But for this case, lengthwise, you can actually fit a pretty long card. I think it's 300 millimeters in the top up here. So I mean, you've got, you know, you don't have to use an ITX card or anything like that. You can actually fit a full size graphics card, which is extremely nice.
Jack.
Our 4-pin extension has arrived.
Coming to our rescue.
Thank you, Jack.
Thank you, sir. Ooh, fit this guy. Let's right get in here.
And Yusuf Khan asked, if I bought all the PC parts, can I send it to you to build it for me? No.
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 Sorry.
Your best bet is to look for a local, like, mom and pop shop
that
can help you out with that.
You know what, Ryan? I think.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to unplug the 24-pin.
You're running around it?
And just kind of running around it.
Okay.
Just for a little bit cleaner.
Okay. Careful there.
Yeah. Be careful.
You're on it. Your clip is off. You just got to come back towards me a little bit. With the... It's coming out. There you go.
And there we go. Yeah, that'll be much better. So this uses a little bit different. We don't have screws that go directly into it. We have kind of a vanity plate, but it also clips in.
Mm-hmm.
So we've got two long thumb screws that you take out, and you just take this off, and you can actually see it has two little posts right here that are used to secure the graphics card in instead of screws.
Instead of screws.
Yep. Let's remove our covers.
Okay. And there was a question from CartDog TV asking about the CPU cooler compatibility in this case. There's plenty of room for this radiator.
Oh, yeah.
You could realistically use one that's significantly thicker if you wanted to as well.
Yeah, you could. So, I mean, the only thing you would need to take into consideration if you were wanting to use this SSD tray for any reason, mm-hmm. then you would need to make sure how your tubes are out and everything like that.
Right. Yeah, if you see a warning on the site, or not a warning, but a note about it, it generally just means that they haven't provided a max radiator depth
right.
In the manufacturer specs.
Right. All right, so we're going to place our card in.
Okay. Slide it over there. You got to kind of tuck this one under a little bit. It's very tight tolerance. There we go.
Yep. Just push it down, and you do actually have to kind of lift the case up a little bit if you have the sides off.
Right.
Because the ends of the card will stick through, and you'll kind of be pushing down trying to figure out why it's not yeah. going in.
Yeah, we went through that briefly. Yeah.
So then we'll just kind of hold it up here, and then you just basically, it just clips in.
Mm-hmm.
Your card is secure. Let me screw the screws back in. I have to turn this towards me.
Yeah, you have a little bit of a better angle there.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, it is a very good-looking card, SNJ Virtual. The only downside to me is that there's no backplate on it. I would love to see a white backplate.
Right. It doesn't have a backplate. In this case, though,
mm-hmm.
it's perfect because you're showing off the part of the card that is the extremely beautiful part. All right, so next, we're going to go ahead and plug in our PCIe power. And with the PCIe power, so you don't want to run it this way. Because you actually have no clearance here
right.
when you start pushing
it. Cannot run it over that bar.
Right. So you just want to slot it up and under.
Mm-hmm.
And around. Same thing with this one. Up and under and around. And then just plug it in from there. Watch your head.
And we have compatibility restrictions in place for this case as well.
Yes.
Because your card, the height of the card, from the bottom, from the X16 up, can only be so tall. You essentially have to have a reference size cooler. You might get away with slightly taller cars that have recessed power plugs.
Yes. There we go.
There we go.
Push it in. And you do want to kind of hold your card when you're pushing it in because you are kind of pushing on to nothing back
yeah,
here.
Yeah,
so
definitely give it a little bit of support.
Yeah, and you can see right now, we talked about this bar is kind of where you want to stop.
Mm-hmm.
You can kind of see once the cables are in here and everything like that, you start pushing really close.
Yeah.
So. All right, we have our graphics card in. We have our M.2. We have our RAM. We have our cooler.
Mm-hmm.
I think we're ready for the case. Here, and it will only go in one way.
Right.
And this is not.
And that's not the way.
So there. Yep. There we go.
Okay.
That's on there. So here is. Turn around this way.
Turn around so you can see it there.
So that's basically how everything goes in. And it's got a rail that we'll put it on.
Right.
So if you want to hand the actual case over here, I'm going to slide this inside because we are going to put a Cable Mods RGB strip along the top of it to kind of help show off this white. White case and white graphics card.
Mm-hmm. It's still a little bit appealing to do at the top of the case.
Yes,
so that'll be fun.
So we're using a Cable Mods 60 centimeter and 30 centimeter strip.
Okay.
So in this part will take a little bit finesse. So I'm just going to put it in right now to where I kind of think it'll work, and then we'll see. Once we get it booted, how it turns out.
Yeah. And then SNJ Virtual is asking about the airflow of the case. We'll be letting them know. We're going to run hardware monitor and then run a bench.
Yep.
And so we'll give you an idea of the idle temperatures and then the load temperatures running a benchmark.
And it does have vents along the front right here, mm-hmm. up here, and then along the back to pull in air and then push right. air, push air out. Magnetic side.
Yep.
And all we're doing with this is we just want to light up the card.
Mm-hmm.
And this nice window that they give us.
Well, it's nice too that it's a white card, so if you do like rainbow crazy LEDs, you know, there's no LEDs on the card, but you can kind of light up that white yes. cooler. Yes. With your LEDs. So.
And here's, like I was saying earlier, people were worried about the fan catching the cables. Mm-hmm. It's got this little slot right here that we're basically going to slide the cables down in, run them around, and then kind of, as we push them in, I'll kind of be pulling the cables right. in so that they're not rubbing against the fan.
So all the cables should be in the main chamber instead right. of in the front of the case.
Yes. Just go ahead and get them
somewhat, started. Yeah.
Situated in here. Start with the HD audio.
Okay.
Not trying to get my head in it.
Yeah, I know.
Very back.
It gets a little darker and darker.
Yeah.
the higher the sides come up.
Alright.
Sure.
Got it
all. Yep. HD audio. Alright.
Alright, now we're going to do our USB 3.0. It's basically just got a little notch on it.
It'll match up with the motherboard.
Yep, so it should only fit one way into the connector.
Yep.
It's a 20 pin.
It's in there. Now, the front I.O. Which, it's got it nice and labeled.
Awesome.
And you can actually see it pretty well.
Awesome.
So we will start.
But if for whatever reason that you can't, it's also, in your manual.
Yeah,
it's in always manual. In your manual.
RLED, power switch. We'll start with a power switch. Right here. Power LED.
Okay.
So we got a reset switch. And then our hard drive LED.
Which doesn't, no hard drives in this build. And an SSD.
All right. So this will be the,
let me go ahead and plug in. Our
RGB LED strips.
Yeah, our RGB LED strips. I'm going to pull this through this way.
And we did use an adapter, correct?
Correct. We did need to use an adapter that came with the cable mods kit.
Because there are conflicting standards that some of the headers are RGB, GRB, and the cables are different.
Yes.
So.
All right. So you basically pull the slide out, and you've got this little notch right here, which is going to go into also a little notch on the bottom
okay.
of the case. So.
And there are a couple others. There's like a couple pins at the bottom, too, that fit yeah. in as well.
Yeah.
So it should feel solidly
it should definitely
on that just... riser or on that slider.
Yep. There we go.
Oh, first try.
All right.
Just kind of
as I push it in, I'm just kind of be pulling some of those front cables through just so that it aren't hitting that fan.
Mm-hmm.
That's our build.
Ooh,
before I screw it in, just want to do a quick power boot,
mm-hmm.
And I actually can then screw it in after that.
You want to peel the top off first?
Ooh, yes. Yeah.
Yeah. Why don't we do that?
Alrighty.
Actually, let me peel it from this way, because that way is where it wants to go.
It's done.
Do you want to?
Sure, I'll do the honors. Got our LEDs in there, lighting up.
Yep.
There we go.
There we
Perfect.
Go.
All right.
So I'm going to go ahead and bring up Hardware Mon.
Okay. So we get an idea of the temperatures here, and we'll scroll through it so you can see it. And looks like 32C on the graphics card right now. And now I can't see the CPU.
Sorry.
No, you're fine. But we'll have a min and max.
We'll go with the Firestrike Ultra.
Yeah, let's check and see if it's 4K ready.
Yep.
Probably a good time to go over some of our thoughts about the case.
And yeah. So the case, I love the look of it. I'm always one that likes something that is different, mm-hmm. and this is definitely different. It's got a nice look for it. I wouldn't mind having it sitting on my desk. It's not going to too glamoury, I don't think, if that's not your thing, but it's definitely unique in the way that it's got this nice top panel window. You get to see the part of the graphics card that you normally don't get to see.
Right, which it's always pointed
times,
down.
Yeah, which a lot of times this bottom art on the cards is one of the best parts of the card.
Right.
Building in the case, you have to do some steps a little bit different than you normally would, but that's the case with any case.
Yeah. As you get smaller and smaller in cases, it happens more frequently.
Right. So you just want to take your time, kind of plan ahead, see how stuff fits, maybe change it around some, see if it fits better, mm-hmm. if something seems tight or just doesn't seem right. But building in the case, I thought it was great. It wasn't hard. Everything was laid out nicely. They've got room for everything. You can tell that they've thought ahead with how they have. You can actually mount a front radiator, so you've got air that can pull in and everything like that. So you still get the look of the case, but you're not sacrificing airflow.
Right, and they've got the little things too. Like you mentioned, they've smart places to route the cables.
Right,
which is always good to see. You know, sometimes they have great cases, and then you're like, well, where do my cables go?
Yeah, exactly.
But that's not the case here with this case.
Yeah.
It's also whisper quiet right now. And
yeah.
that's, you know, it's partially our selection. We have a CLC and we have a triple fan graphics card, but I mean, I really can't hear much of anything right now. A little bit of a little bit of a fan.
Right. Yeah. Maybe just a hair. And honestly, one of my favorite parts of the case, and it would take up more desk space if you did this, but it's kind of, you know, you got this nice window and everything like that, but sometimes you want to show off just how you open it. Just like I would look for reasons to be like, oh, I need to check something. Let me just open the case. That's fine. Let me just push it back.
Now. Reminds me of the Portal VR Labs
game. Oh, where you pull it out.
Open a robot up.
Yeah.
And, yeah. Very much so.
Yeah, but I thought it was great.
It'll be on our desk or somebody's desk at DreamHack.
Yeah, it will. So if you're at DreamHack and you're in the BYOC, so you may see it.
Yeah. Well, there was a comment from SNJ Virtual again. Wow, the 80mm silent. That surprised me the most. I have very bad experience with tiny fans, and it's not bad at all. And
it is actually on.
Yeah, I can't speak to the fact that if you ran it off Molex, how loud it would be.
Right.
But right now, plugged into the fan header, I mean, it's
great.
It's great. Nope, that's it.
There we go.
Oh, we're way over.
Oh yeah.
6800. I think they put 4K at like 5500.
Something like
we
that.
We'll pull it up here. We've got the website there.
So what's this?
Yeah, full screen that up there. Yeah, better than 79% of all results. That's with no overclocking, no custom liquid cooling.
Yeah, that's pretty well. It's past the 4K gaming.
Right.
So if you wanted the game at 4K at 60, this card should be able to handle it. Let's take a look at our temperatures real quick.
Sure. CPU max was 62, GPU max 71, and SSD was 67.
That's perfect.
So,
yeah,
those are great numbers. I mean, the GPU at 71 and CPU at 62 give you plenty of room to overclock.
Yeah, you do have some nice headroom.
And obviously, we're not like running fans at max. We're not pumping them, you know, for the best benchmark score possible.
Right. We've not adjusted any fan profiles or anything like that. So this is just all stock, as you would just build it and boot it for the first time.
Yeah. So thanks for watching us and joining us for another successful build video. And a big thanks to BitPhoenix for the case.
And MSI for the motherboard.
And if you enjoyed the content or learned anything new, please give us a like, subscribe, and follow.